Hi everyone, welcome to the Analyzing Census Data in SAS Studio tutorial series. In this video, I'll show you how you can access and download data that the US Census Bureau makes available. Then, you'll learn to prepare this data for import into SAS Studio. You'll see how to import data in the next video. If you want to follow along with me, make sure you watch the introduction video to set up your environment and tutorial data. You can find the link to it below or on the main tutorial page. Let's jump right in. So the first thing I'm going to do is in a browser, I'm going to go to data.census.gov. So data.census.gov is going to provide a centralized platform to access demographic and economic data from the United States Census Bureau. Now, this is actually not the only interactive tool that the Census Bureau makes available to access data, but it's the one that we'll be using throughout this tutorial series. Once you get to data.census.gov on this main landing page, there's two main ways you can go about looking for the data that you're interested in. You can use the free form single search bar, and you can do this if you are just wanting to look for a quick statistic or you're looking for a profile for a single geography. Or you can alternatively take advantage of advanced search. And this is more for your complex searches, like a particular survey, a program, or a table. I want to take advantage of advanced search. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the button that says advanced search. And now I have a list of filters I can use to narrow down the results or tables that will appear. For this video, I am interested in median home values. So the first filter that I'm going to apply is I'm going to go to the topics filter. I'll go into housing, because again, it's median home values. And let's click on where it says financial characteristics. We have several options here. I'm going to go with the checkbox for housing value and purchase price, because again, median home values, that sounds about right. There's other filters I can apply. I'm just going to do one more for this example here. I'm going to click on years on the browse filters on the left-hand side. And for this tutorial series, I will stick with 2018 data, so I'll select that checkbox. You'll notice at the bottom, as I select my filters, you see them applied at the bottom, selected filters. Now that I have those filters in place, I will click search. And let's take a look at the results that we get. Right now, we are on the all results page. And here I can choose to look at tables that are available, some maps, or pages that satisfy those filters that I just applied. I'm interested in actual tables, so at the top of the page, I will click on tables. And now I see a list of tables on the left-hand side that I can choose from. For this example, I'm going to select on where it says median values, parentheses, dollars. And the table ID that I'll be using here is B25077. When I selected that, I can actually see that table appear up on the right-hand side. And because I didn't apply any sort of geographic filter, I just see the statistic summarized at the national level. Particularly if you look at the product drop-down menu, you see that this is for 2018. It is the one-year estimates detail table. So what do I mean by one-year estimate? And where is this data actually coming from? Well, on data.census.gov, there's data from multiple surveys and censuses. And in this course, we will use data which comes from the American Community Survey. In short, we can call it ACS. The ACS is the nation's largest ongoing household survey, and it provides social, economic, housing, and demographic data every year. Now, the ACS is based on a sample. So you'll notice here in the table that there is a margin of error that is provided to account for any of those sampling errors. In addition to that, they make available one-year and five-year estimates. Five-year estimates are available for many geographical areas, all the way down to the block group level, while one-year estimates are only available for all areas that have a population of 65,000 or more, and for metro or micropolitan statistical areas with a population of 50,000 or greater. In this class, we will analyze data at the regional and state levels, and we're going to use the ACS one-year estimates. Again, I am interested in the median home values at the state level, not the national level. So, in order to apply a couple more filters and customize this table, I'm going to click on the Customize Table button. When I do that, I actually see this advanced filter menu appears. And some of these filters are actually the same filters that we saw on advanced search. For example, I see a year filter applied for 2018 and the topic that we selected earlier as well. For me, I want to focus now on modifying the geography. So I'm going to click on geographies on that advanced filters menu. I want state level, so I'll click state. And you can pick and choose the states that are of interest to you. I just want all the states, so I'll select a checkbox that says all states in United States. I'll click close. And now you'll see that my table has been updated. I now see the different states represented in here. I have a column, for example, for Colorado, the estimate, as well as the margin of error. And I can just scroll through this table to see all the states being represented. I do want to make a note here. There is a chance that if you're following along with me, the states might appear in a different order, but you'll still have the same data available to you. All right, I have the data that I'm interested in. I am now ready to download this data. So I'll click on where it says download. I'll make sure that the 1 year estimates for 2018, that checkbox is selected, and I'll download this as a CSV file. Click download. Once the files are prepared, I can click download now. And this is going to download a zip file containing the data that I just selected. Let's take a look at that zip file. I'll go ahead and open it up. I'll expand this window a little bit so we can take a look what's in here. You notice that there's actually three files contained in the zip file that I just downloaded. There are two CSV or comma separated values files, as well as a text file in here. The one that we're going to be interested in is the CSV file that contains the word data with overlays in the title. Right? So I'm going to go ahead and double click on that. And this is just going to open up this file in Excel. I just want to take a look at it and make sure we got what we were interested in. So let's take a look here. I'm going to zoom in on this Excel file a little bit more. And I am also going to optimize the view of the columns just so we have enough room. A quick way to do that in Excel, I'm going to, in the upper left-hand corner, click on the Select All triangle. Then on the Home tab in the Cells group, I'll go to Format and then select Auto Fit Column Width. Again, just to make it a little bit easier to see the values here. All right, so let's take a look here. You notice I have a column called GeoID. I have IDs for my different states available, the name of the state. Then I have the mean home value estimate, again, the 1 year estimates for 2018. And then finally in column D, I have that margin of error value as well. Now, at this point, I could actually take this file and import it into SAS Studio as is, and that is totally fine. But in order to simplify the import process a little bit more, and while I already have this file opened up in Excel, I'm going to make just a couple of changes. Again, these changes are not necessary, and you can even do these changes in SAS Studio. I'm just going to do them now, again, to simplify that import process. So first thing I'd like to change are the column names. There are some rules for column names that we have in SAS. So in SAS, column names must be 1 to 32 characters in length. It's recommended that the column name begins with a letter or an underscore, and that it continues on with letters, numbers, or underscores. Now, in addition to those rules, it would be nice if those column names are in the very first row of this file. So let's go ahead and change up these column names. I will leave in cell A1 GeoID as is. But for cell B1 instead of name, let's call this state. Cell C1, I'm going to rename this to median home, one word. And then cell D1, I'll type in median home MOE, again, one word. So that's change number one that I made. Since I have those column names that I want in that very first row, I actually no longer need this second row that has these descriptive labels contained in there, so I'm going to go ahead and delete it. What I'll do is right-click on the row number 2, and then I'll select Delete. Last thing that I'm going to do while I have this file open in Excel is to apply currency formats to columns C and D, because again, these are median home values. They represent currency values. What's nice about formatting them in Excel is that when I import this file into SAS Studio, those currency formats are automatically going to be applied and come through over in SAS Studio. So to apply a format, I'm going to click on the column heading C, hold down my control key, and then also select the column heading D. You can right click anywhere in this highlighted region, select format cells, and then we have the format cells window that pops up. From the category, I'm going to go into the currency category. Let's go ahead and decrease the decimal places to 0 because there are no decimal places to start with. And I'll leave everything else at the default. I'll click OK. And here we have it. Now we see column C and D applied as currency values. That's all I need to do now. So I'm going to go ahead and save this file. I'll go to File, Save As. All right. Feel free to navigate to a location of interest. I'm just going to go in and pick a location. I'm going to name this file Median Home Value. And I could keep this as a CSV file, but to make sure that the formats that I applied are properly saved and that they'll be used whenever I do the importing into SAS Studio, and that Save As Type drop-down list, I'm going to instead choose Excel Workbook with that .xlsx extension at the end. And click Save. That's all I need to do. I have the file ready to go. I can go ahead and now close the median home value.xlsx file. Now you know how to access and download data from data.census.gov. Make sure to try out the practices in the tutorial notes. To learn something new, try out the challenge practice. It'll show you how you can extract just a subset of the data that you see when customizing the table in data.census.gov. Thanks for watching.